Coach Grumulia or Gomiglia. What do you want me? What is it?
Coach Grumulia.
Grumulia? Okay, that's the proper name?
That's the proper Italian way to say it.
Okay. Coach G, as everyone
does.
But we're just going to cut that all out. We're just going to say Coach G. Coach G, phenomenal year for the Wadsworth Grizzlies. Phenomenal year, even how you guys finished. I know it was very disappointing to you and the kids, but let's talk about the year. You guys won pretty much everything. You won two duels against St. Edward. Okay, a barn burner that I came to actually and filmed. It was great.
That was awesome. Yes, it was.
Yeah, when you beat them, where else, the other place you beat them?
At the state duels in Wadsworth. So we beat them at Wadsworth and one at Ed's.
So two great ways to actually win those. Now, you guys won your tournament, right? You won your league tournament for the 37th time in a row. Was it 17th?
It's 17th
time in a row. Okay, Suburban League, Greater Akron area. Just a banner year. Districts.
Yeah, we beat Perry twice, too. By beating them at the duel, state duel, and then we beat them in their own gym. So that was kind of our goal, to beat both Ed's and Perry at their gym. Because I think that shows a lot to go into someone's house and beat them.
Especially teams like that who've been so dominant through the last decades.
Yeah, there's no disrespect. That makes us work harder, and they have fine coaching staffs and, you know, all of that. But, yeah, it was just that one round. That's what we're calling it.
I want to talk about that. I know you've probably taken it and used it as an inspirational tool with your guys, because I know how you operate. But the round, you guys are winning by a point and a half or a point?
I think it was 1 point.
1 point going into the semifinal round, Division I state tournament. You're beating, who are you beating? You're at the second.
Edward, Perry, Brecksville, Ignatius, you name it. You know, Westerville North was up there. Everything was falling in line. And we had 6 in the semis and 3 in the Russell backs, and I think we lost every one in that.
You went 0-9.
0-9.
In the semifinal round, 0-6, and then in that Russell back, you went
0-9. And there were some people that were happy about that.
Yeah, well, there's going to be people who are happy about it, because then they can win their title.
Well, yeah, but there were other people, but that's all right.
Okay, well, Coach, how have you taken that? How have you spun it to your guys in a positive way, which I know you
have? Well, what we found out is, we lost some really close matches, and some of them got away from us mentally, some of us physically, so we're working on those two tools this summer. And one of them is coming to tough camps and going and lifting a little bit. We've been, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we're coming in our weight room at 7 a.m., and just the wrestlers are coming in, including football players. We got permission from the Almighty Football to come in, and we weight train all of our kids. Our coaches come in, and some of our volunteers, and that's one way of, I think we felt that we weren't strong enough in those matches, 2-1, Kagan, you know, Bradley, Ben Mazzelli, you look at Nick Tavanello, some of them were, you know, freshmen too, but so we've done that, and then just mentally we've got some things planned to be a little tougher. We're going to go to a team building rappelling course here to kind of bring us together a little bit. And just using it for our experience. We only lost one state placer.
You have 8 back.
Right.
Why are you so...
Well, actually, we had 7 placers, 9 qualifiers, and everyone's back but one, Alex Gray.
Okay. Why are you such a firm believer in the whole team unit thing?
Yeah, it's always been... I think that's just my upbringing, my coaches. It was always family first in our household, and the coaches that I had, Mike Setta at St. Ignatius and Tony DiCarlo at John Carroll, it was always, don't think of yourself first. It's always, you know, your brother next to you. And I just kind of kept that. It just seems like it's an easy formula to follow. And when things happen bad with you individually, you could always still share team-wise. So I think it's kind of a way to kind of have that in your back pocket.
Okay, why do you bring your guys, why do you feel that the Jeff Jordan team camp is such a special thing?
We've come here an awful lot. We've come here individually. I used to send, Zach Kali, Adam Melton, the Timmy Millers. It goes a long way back individually. And I'd come down and watch a couple sessions, and then they started this team camp. And I just thought it's a great way. It's a small camp. They get a lot of individual attention. I can give them a lot of individual attention, but it's... As you can see, it's not a very comfortable place. You have to sleep right where you wrestle. And you have to, like a Ben Bazzelli going through this camp, he's probably going to lose 10 to 12 pounds this week. You know, so it's kind of, the adversity kind of makes you a little tougher mentally.
Okay. Obviously, everybody knows what the goal is next year. Okay, to get up on top. Do you think that you won't put as much stress on the season this year? Or will it be a different, what will you do differently next year to get on top of that state tournament?
There won't be a lot of differences. I mean, our training and our, peaking and all that's going to be the same. I just think that the off season's going to be where we had to change and make a little bit. But, you know, our schedule's a little tougher again. We do wrestle Graham February 5th right here at the Graham on a Friday night. So we have to come down here and on a Friday and do that. And so we picked up a couple things. You know, we're at Ironman again. We go down to Cincinnati, a Harrison tournament, before Ironman because of the schedule now. You know, they gave us, Ironman moved up a week.
Yeah, that opens another weekend up.
Right, so that helped us out. So there's a couple changes in our schedule. You know, there'll be a couple. You know, Bobby Jones is, you know, our strength and conditioning coach, and he always has some things up his sleeve. Josh Hendricks is working at Evolve right now, and he works with Scott Overholt. He comes in and works a lot of the
kettlebells.
Kettlebells and their whole mentality. So we've been doing a lot of that.
All right, Coach G, is there anything else you got for me?
I just, you know, appreciate you guys always following us and giving us so much publicity, and hopefully we can handle it this time.
All right, Coach G, thanks for the time.
Thanks.